Hey everybody, Josh coming to you live today on Josh's Barefoot Shoes Reviews. Today we're not actually doing a review per se. We are blasting through 9 different sandal manufacturers. Barefoot Sandal Central here for 2023. So if you're shopping for barefoot sandals in 2023, you're going to want to check out this video in depth. Before we get to that though, real quick, hit like, hit subscribe, hit the notification bell, and you're also going to want to follow me on Instagram at Barefoot Shoe Josh. Barefoot Shoe Josh. Why? Because my reviews there are more in-depth than what I do on my YouTube videos. Lots of details there, plus cool pics of barefoot shoes and sandals on your Instagram feed. So follow me on Instagram, Barefoot Shoe Josh. Let's get into it. Like I mentioned today, it's not a review per se. I do have reviews, I believe, of every single one of these sandals on the channel. So if you see something that interests you, go watch that detailed review. It'll give you a little bit more information than what I can give you here, covering 9 different manufacturers, 10 different sandals today. But there's a lot of barefoot shoe sandals on the market, and these are the top brands by far. If you're shopping, these are 9 brands that you're definitely going to want to look at. Now, I want to say that each one of these models, each one of these manufacturers, rather, has different models. So if the model I'm holding up doesn't necessarily interest you, you're still going to want to check out their website, see what other models they have. There's different colors, different sole thicknesses, different strapping styles, all kinds of different stuff. So these are just more about like noticing the brands. And if you happen to like the model that I have here that I'm showing you, great. If not, you still want to check it out. If you're doing serious barefoot sandal shopping, you're going to want to do that. Also, I want to mention, I'm not doing these in any particular order, really. I have scored them in depth on my Instagram site, on my Instagram page, so you might notice that. But I want to say that all of these brands are great brands. I'm not starting like with number one because it's the best brand. I am going to give you my top 3 go-to sandals that I most reach for, but that says more about me than it does about the brand, okay? Because I have very particular tastes, you have different tastes. And so my favorite brand might not be your favorite brand. So I'm not trying to say anything about the quality of each of these brands or anything like that. I'm just telling you, these are all awesome brands. And here's some things that you might want to check out. So with that in mind, let's get to it. All right. I have a lot of information here. So here is, I will say this, you know, might be one of my very favorite barefoot sandals because barefoot shoes, barefoot footwear of any kind, because it is almost like wearing nothing. Genyala Sandala. This is a company out of Austria, I think. Dear God, forgive me if I'm wrong about that. Go check out the detailed review. But look at this thing. 3 millimeters thick. Now, I will say all of these sandals meet the barefoot sandal criteria. Okay, they're all zero drop, meaning no heels, no toe springs. It's just a flat surface to stand on. There's no arch support of any kind. They're all different types of anatomic foot shapes. So that's one of the considerations that you're going to want to look at when you're looking for your barefoot sandals, to find something that's similar to your foot shape. All right. And what else? They're all going to be very, very flexible and stuff like that. Different degrees of flexibility depending on how thick the sole is, as well as if you go on their website and get a different model with a thicker sole, obviously that's going to vary the flexibility and things like that. Okay. So there you go. Genyala Sandala. These, what do I have to say about these? These are unisex DIY sandals, do-it-yourself sandals. So basically you get a sole. They have, you know, I don't know, 4 or 5 different models. They have vegan models and leather models, but they're all ultra thin, 3 millimeters. That's including the footbed, which is either leather or vegan leather, as well as the recycled rubber sole on the bottom. And you can do, for the strapping, either nylon or organic hemp. So those are the choices. And then you just basically choose a couple different color options and things like that. Get the color of strap that you like and tie it any way you like. It's do it yourself. So these guys run about 55 euros and up, depending. My particular model was 63 euros, plus you pay shipping. But if you use my code Josh Barefoot, you get 5% off. I know. Hey, awesome. So that's them. These are my favorites. These are the most like wearing nothing. So this is definitely one of my quick go-tos. Oh, the weight. I wanted to say, doggone the weight. Oh, 5.2 ounces per sandal. That's less than, that's like 10 and a half ounces for the pair of sandals. By far the lightest, most like wearing nothing sandal you can find. And again, if this isn't your shape foot, you buy it a little bit bigger size, you cut it just like I did to match your shape of foot. That's cut to match my foot. So if that's not your shape of foot, you can easily, I mean, on my review video, you see me cutting them and how easy it is. So anyway, Ganyala Sandala, awesome sandals. One of my top three go-tos. One of my other top three go-tos. Here we go. Pies sucios. That means dirty feet. It's because the company is in Spain. That's why the name is in Spanish. Pies sucios. Now these, as I mentioned, I think they have four or five different models. I chose, again, their lightest, thinnest, which again is why this is one of my three go-tos. Another reason is that when they're sitting on the ground, they kind of hold their shape, which means to me, as the lazy person that I am, I like to just stick my foot in there, wiggle, wiggle, my toes are in place, and then I just grab the heel strap and whoop, right over my heel. And this is the same reason I like the next model that we're going to talk about in a minute. But ultra thin, ultra flexible. What can I say about Pies Sucios? Made in Spain. They are vegan. Ultra light, again, 2.3 ounces for the size 42. So, you know, up or down from there, depending on your size. These are 6mm Vibram soles. You know, so pretty good thin. And ultra grip rubber sole. Oh, sorry, wrong one. 6mm Vibram soles. They do have thicker ones if you want. These run about 50 euros and up plus shipping. If you use my code JOSH5OFF, J-O-S-H, the number 5, O-F-F, you get 5% off. All right, and that's that. Okay, on to Shama sandals. I have two models of Shama sandals, and I've owned another one that got stolen from me, and you can hear about that on my other review if you want to hear that story. But so I have the Black Warriors and the All Browns. So which one can we do first? Let's do the Warriors. Again, you'll notice a recurring theme here. These look just like my Pies Sucios. They're black, sitting flat on the ground. They kind of hold their shape. I can wiggle my foot in there, flip the strap over my heel. Done. Ultra thin, 5-ish millimeter Vibram soles with the grippy. You see, I wear the heck out of these things. These are definitely one of my top three go-tos. I probably almost wear these at every day at some point, running out to the mail or doing something. What else can I say? Warriors are around 65 bucks. They're only 3 ounces in a men's size 9. So again, very, very light. Leather straps. I'm sorry, I'm reading the wrong one. 2.5 millimeter sole plus 3 millimeter tread gives you about a 5.5 millimeter total stack height. Very, very thin. And Vibram Ultra Grip rubber soles. Boom. There we go. Shama Warriors. And now the Shama All Browns, these are the ones that I was saying, all leather straps. You can see the nice kind of suede-ish back to those. And then the finished leather on the other side of the strap. Nice and smooth, just like the footbed, leather footbed. Thicker soles. These guys have a thicker sole. I didn't write down how thick. I'm so sorry. Again, this isn't a review. Go watch the detailed review. But just another Shama model, and you can see the foot shape that comes with those. And I believe, actually, Shama does do custom work if you want to pay extra. I'm not 100% sure on that, but I believe I've heard that through the rumor mill. But yeah, All Browns. Great. Okay, love Shama sandals. So those are my top three. Shama sandals, Pies Sucios, and Ganyala Sandala. Those are my three top three go-to, reach for them almost every time I'm going to put on sandals. And then I have other models that I put on for different reasons. Maybe it's the color that matches my outfit. Maybe I'm going to go to SeaWorld for the day, and I'm going to be standing around on hot pavement all day. I'm going to go for a little thicker sole. Maybe I choose my dressier model, whatever it is. So here's the other models. Okay, on to Unshoes Kyoto model. Here we go. Boom. There it is. That's what it looks like. Slip your foot in there. It's got this strap that comes right down the middle of your foot, which is also one of the reasons I like that Pies Sucios. And the way I've kind of got my Shamas rigged up, and the way I've got my Ganyala Sandalas rigged up, I like the strap to come right down straight down the top of my middle foot, right into the gap between my toes, rather than coming in from the side. So that's just me. And it's got this elastic band, which is kind of an unusual feature of the Unshoes, which does great for the fitting. So once you get the straps exactly tied up the way you want them, it's easy. You just slip your foot in there and it stretches to go on. So really good grippy sole for your feet. Nice little tread pattern. There's the anatomic foot shape. Actually, they have different shapes. So they have the stock models, which run about 63 bucks, or the kids are 45. If you want to pay, instead of $63, you want to go up to $75, you get a custom foot shape, and they have 6 different foot shapes. So this is the one that was most like my foot. So I selected this one. I selected the color, and there you go. Pretty good thin sole. I don't know if I have 7 to 8 millimeter total stack height, but again, they have other models with different strappier styles. Check those out. They also have some shoes that I like. I have some slip-on shoes from them. Great company out of Utah. Use my code Josh Barefoot if you want to save 10% on these guys. So that's Unshoes. All right. What else? We got Field Grounds, Seaside Sandals. Okay, so here we go. Really styling sandal. You know, I the one comment I'll make about these is this particular style on the front here, a little bit on the feminine side, but I'll still rock them because I'm comfortable with my masculinity. But you might not like it. So anyways, but I like the color. It matches, you know, certain, matter of fact, it matches the shirt I have on now. Oh, by the way, check out this shirt. Boom. The Madonna surfing. This is made from a public art installation here locally in San Diego. I loved it so much I made a t-shirt out of it, but that's another note. So Field Ground sandals, what can I say about these guys? The Seaside sandals, they're vegan, cotton and elastic uppers. You see that? They got that little bit of stretch to fit you right. Sorry. Or they're around $89. I forgot to mention, oh no, I did mention the price of the Unshoes. These are $89. The link is below. I'm unsure if you get a discount or not, and you're going to find that a recurring theme on a couple more in the remainder. So I just, all the details with the codes and the links and the discounts and all that stuff, I'm not always great at that. So, but use my link, please. Anyways, it would help me out if this video or any of my videos helps you. Please use my links if you can. All right. $89, unsure of a discount. 7 millimeter total stack height. Unisex. They are true to size. And again, they kind of hold their shape when they're sitting on the ground, so easy to slip your foot in. Once you get them set up, they're set up. And that's that. Love those Field Grounds. All right, now I have a couple of custom models. Actually, maybe I should save these custom models till the end because that's a little unusual ground. Oh, I wanted to show you kind of the foot shape of the Field Ground. So if that helps you, see if it matches your foot shape. Okay, so we'll go to a couple of classics. These are longtime favorites in the barefoot shoe world, Earth Runners and Luna Sandals. Okay, so first we'll just do Earth Runners real quick. I got the Elemental model. Is that right? Oh my God. Earth Runners Elemental model. They're $79 and up, the various models they have there. Mine were $79. That's the cheapest model. And I love them because, you know, again, they're pretty darn thin. I don't have the exact millimeters there, check my other review, but they're 5/8 nylon webbing, really light, really lightweight on these. That's one of my favorite parts about these, and I also like the surface of this sole. I don't know what the heck it is. They call it gum light, a Vibram gum light sole. It's got a nice little grip on the bottom. You see that? Nice little grippiness, but this is like it almost has like a foam slash leather feel. I don't know what the surface is, and it's actually pretty similar to these, doggone Pies Sucios. It's got an interesting surface that feels really good and natural on my feet. Like, you know, the Shama sandals, the one thing I'll say on this model, you know, the rubber on your feet, it's rubber. This have leather. I like the touch of leather on my feet. But this stuff and what's on the Pies Sucios, I really like it. It's kind of a comfortable, grippy, but not cuts your skin off from all air sort of feeling. So I really love these. One quirk of these is that the strap does come in pretty hard from the side. So when it goes between your two little toes, it can kind of wrap over one side of, you'll kind of feel it on the side of your toe versus coming straight in like that. If you can understand my little finger analogy there. But these are classics. Elemental by Earth Runners. And they have several models, several thicknesses, a couple different strapping styles, all that stuff. So I love these though. They're lightweight. They're pretty. I love the yellow color and they have lots of different colors to choose from. So go grab some of those. All right. Luna sandals, another barefoot sandal classic. Boom. Look at that. They got the same grippy soles, it looks like, as the Shamas. I should say this about the Earth Runners. See the little copper grounding plug? And they have copper threading in the nylon strapping, which for grounding purposes. So if you're familiar with earthing, grounding, those kind of things, boom, you'll be interested in these. Those are the Earth Runners. And also, these Luna sandals are a classic barefoot sandal. High quality stuff, been around a long time, know what they're doing. Several different models, again, colors and all that stuff. these guys I will wear because when they have, you know, a little thicker sole, if I'm going to be running around for the day and pavement, standing around a lot, that kind of thing, I want a little extra cushion. I'll go for something like this or my Earth Lights. All right. So that's that. Oh, Luna sandals, I should say. Their cheapest one is their DIY model. They have one of those as well, $70. All the other ones are $95 and up. These were about $115. This is the Leadville Pacer model, but they have trail models, they have street models, etc., etc. Check them all out. They're a classic for a reason. I have a link for them down below. Not sure if you get a discount or not. Check that out. 4.45 ounces on the men's 9 on these, so fairly light and great strapping, and that's it. All right, last two models. The reason they're different is they're custom. Okay, so if you're like me, well, first of all, I have extra wide feet. I've been wearing barefoot sandals 10 plus years. My feet have spread out, all that kind of thing. Sometimes, you know, standard sandals don't always fit. More so even with shoes, because then you have the walls of the shoes pressing in on the sides of your feet or on the top, and that gets uncomfortable sometimes. So if you have wide feet, or you have somehow, you know, maybe one foot's bigger than the other, some people have dramatically one foot bigger than the other, or any other unusual feet configurations, I'll say, look at doing something custom. Or if you just want to be quirky and have your own sandals that nobody in the world else in the world has, grab some custom sandals. I have two different brands for you. First, we'll do Paisley running sandals. Boom. Again, these have, I got the fairly basic nylon. What do they call this style? I don't know. I can't find it that fast. I'm staring at my notes. But they have some strappier models if you like strappier toes. I notice a lot of people do like those. But the reason I got this particular one is because I figured I was going to luxe it out. Just make it like, you know, luxury central, right? So I got a memory foam footbed covered by suede. Hello? Who doesn't like suede on their feet? And I love this style of toe strapping, this little nylon cord. There's a few brands that do that. And that's always very comfortable. And so that was just primarily what I was going for. I'm going for black. I'm going to go luxe. There's the soles. But again, different style soles, different styles, colors, materials, footbeds, straps, colors, everything. You can just custom it out, do whatever you want to do. They have rainbow sandals, anything you want to do. If you need something custom, Matt Paisley, he is a coach. Yeah, he's a full-time teacher and coach. He makes these at home, and this is his little business. And dude, you trace around your feet. And he makes sandals that fit your shape of feet. That's my oddball shape of feet right there. It looks like I got snowshoes on, but that's my feet for you. So love it, love it, love it. All right, and I don't have any discount codes or affiliate links or anything for them. He just does his thing. He doesn't give discounts. He just does his thing. And I will say also, the first time we made them, I had some adjustments that he shipped them to me, and I tried them on. I said, oh, you know, can we change this or this? I shipped them back to him. He fixed them, no problem, sent them right back to me. Really great customer service from Matt Paisley. All right, last custom one is from Deliberate Life Designs. And these are made by Adam Pashaus. I'm going to butcher his name. But he and his wife and his kids live in a converted school bus in Vermont. And they have cool Instagram accounts, one for the shoes and one for just their bus life. And so if you can look up Deliberate Life on Instagram, you can find both of those and follow them on Instagram. So here's the one I opted for this time. They use recycled climbing rigging stuff for the straps, which is very cool, rather than just throwing a landfill somewhere. He makes these sandals out of it, but the straps are brand new. Don't worry, they're not going to be like ragged or anything. They are beautiful. And I got a suede footbed again. I'm just figuring, man, if I'm going to get something custom, I'm going to get something that my feet really love to stand on. You can see my little toe prints. And cut out to my weird shape of feet. Again, get your shape of feet. Get your type of sole. And these, where's my dang notes? They start at $89. Mine were about $111 with a discount. And if you use my code JoshBarefoot, you get a discount on these, 10% off. I got the Pursuit model. It's got a 7 to 8 millimeter sole. And they have two different styles. The Swarovski style with the single strap, like most barefoot sandals you see. They also have a duo one where the strap goes straight across the top of your feet. If you like that style, they have that style as well. And blah, 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 blah. That's it. All right. I don't think I told you anything about the prices on the Paisley. So the Paisleys are $90 and up. Mine were about $100 or so, give or take. And so that's that. So almost 20 minutes, guys. Longest video ever. I'm sorry for that, but I'm not sorry for that because hopefully you got some good information here. You've got 9 good brands, the best 9 brands of barefoot sandals in the world to go check out. Find the model that suits you best. Find the color you like, the thickness, the flexibility, the color, the strapping style. If you look at those 9 brands, you're going to find something you like. And if you would, please use my links below. Use my discount codes. By all means, save money. Save 5% here, 10% there. It all adds up. And it helps me out as well. So I appreciate it. Thanks for watching this long video. Hope to catch you on the next go around. Talk to you soon. Bye.